Please be seated. Lizzie, I'm going to try not to look at you because I'm going to cry if I do. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the presence of friends and family to celebrate the marriage of Jacob Stevens and Elizabeth Oxender. These two invited you here from all over the country to witness their pledge to one another for eternity. Jacob and Lizzie have been together for 5 years now, and each year they have grown closer, they have grown stronger, but perhaps most importantly of all, they've grown to understand each other's shortcomings. We are born into this world flawed, and through self-development and patience, we can start to smooth over some of our rough edges. We can start to fill in some of our cracks. But as individuals, we will always be flawed. We must rely on others, therefore. Friends, family, and perhaps most important of all, a husband or wife. Jacob and Lizzie, I was hoping to start today off with a little bit of advice. As I was born 3 weeks earlier than my cousin, I am much older, and as such, much wiser, and I feel justified on lecturing her on her wedding day. That being said, this advice doesn't only come from me, but from friends and family who I met with leading up to this date. So I'm gonna have to read through some of this. I don't have this section memorized. I just got some of this last night, but here goes. Marriage is not a 50-50 partnership. It is 100%, 100% commitment. You need to be all in. Halfway does not reward you with a life of love. Go all the way, Barb. Follow your heart, Trevor. Jacob, you can be happy or you can be right, Uncle Tim's. In my experience, there's no such thing as luck, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Keep tabletop games and video games the only games that you play against each other. Your teamwork will always bring home the win. Danielle. Don't listen to what everyone else has to say. At the end of the day, it's the two of you. Thomas. Keep your sense of humor. Molly. You're only as strong as you are united, as weak as you are divided. Albus Dumbledore. Remember, if things get rough, rock bottom can be a very strong footing to start to build up from. That one's me. Compromise, compromise, compromise. That's marriage, Svetlana. Be kind and always say thank you, Richard. Women always find out the truth. Always, Han Solo. Don't ever go to bed mad, Papa. Happy marriage is like a well-tended garden. Tend to your commitment by honoring the friendship, playfulness, love, and devotion that brought you two together, Aunt Julie. I am looking for someone to share in an adventure, Gandalf. Always make sure you carry snacks for your spouse, Chris. Love each other so much that love becomes inevitable, Nand. Always in motion, the future is, Master Yoda. When you're playing, remember to share your toys, Brody. Always accept each other for who, Always accept each other for who they are, Uncle Tom. Love is never late, nor is it early. It arrives precisely when it means to, Gandalf. Never wash Lizzie's whites with her darks, Maddie. A wise man once told me, if you don't have fun, it's your own damn fault. Emily. Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times if you only remember to turn on the light. Albus Dumbledore. Marriage is tough. Colin. Marriage is tough. So may your only ups and downs be between the sheets. Colin. Marriage is a compromise. When things get hard, be kind to each other, Dan. And lastly, live long and prosper, Mr. Spock. The two of you will continue to grow and change, and this advice will hardly cover every obstacle that comes your way, but it can be a strong foundation to start to build your guys' future on. Up next, I feel like I would be missing an opportunity if I didn't discuss your guys' engagement. I'm sure that everyone here has seen the video, but being close to the bride and groom, I got to learn some of the behind-the-scenes footage. Anyone here who hasn't seen the video, Jacob proposed to Lizzie off the coast of Bonaire while they were scuba diving. Scuba's been one of the activities that's really brought these two together, and they never miss an opportunity to strap on their tanks and their flippers. As such, Jacob thought it would be the perfect way to propose to Lizzie. Might have made for an awkward dive if she had said no, though. In any case, Lizzie and Jacob jumped into the ocean over Angel City on October 9th, 2019, with Jacob a little more nervous than normal. Jacob was searching for a sandy area that was not too deep in case someone spit out their regulator. He found an area that looked good, and with a little bit of prior planning and some fibbing through Lizzie's father, they dove down. Unfortunately, this was only the beginning of Jacob's struggles, though. Upon reaching the bottom, Jacob had to find a way to get Lizzie's attention. This proved to be exceedingly difficult, as my cousin, Lizzie, the scuba diver, is afraid of fish. Every time Jacob would reach out and touch her, Lizzie would think it was a fish and swim away. In no time at all, Jacob's perfectly sandy area to kneel became filled with coral. When he did finally catch up to Lizzie and get her attention, he placed his knees straight down into a tower of fire coral. I'm happy to say that this was the end of Jacob's bad luck, though. As he wrestled the ring from his diving belt, Lizzie emphatically shook her head yes, and these two got to take their first walk as an engaged couple 25 feet below the surface of the Caribbean Sea. I love that story. But more importantly, I think there are some great lessons that the two of you can take forward from it. First off, it's hard to talk under the sea. But you two have practiced a set of skills that allow you to communicate underwater. Use those skills in your everyday lives. People don't always tell someone when something's bothering them, but if you two can understand each other 25 feet under the surface of the ocean, swimming in monster soup, you can certainly tell when the other person has had a rough day. Sometimes in love, you have to chase someone around for a while trying to get their attention. But if that person loves you back, the time and effort that you put in will always be worth it. Never be afraid to kneel in some fire coral. If the temporary pain that it causes you will bring the two of you closer together or make life easier for your partner. And lastly, if your marriage started 25 feet under the surface of the ocean, there's loads of pressure down there. And if you two can handle the pressure down there, you can handle any pressure that comes your way up here. At this point, I would like to ask Billy Oxender, Lizzie's brother, to come forward and do a reading. Where's the mic? Right over here, Bill.
I'm not very good at speeches, but here we go. This is a reading from Tolkien. Roads go ever on, over rock and under tree, by caves where never sun has shone, by streams that never find the sea, over snow by winter sown, and through the merry flowers of June, over grass and over stone, and under mountains in the moon. Roads go ever on, under cloud and under star, yet feet that wandering have gone turn at last to home afar. Eyes that fire and sword have seen, and horror in the halls of stone, look at last on meadows green. And trees and hills they long have known. The road goes ever on and on, down from the door where it began. Now far ahead the road has gone, and I must follow if I can. pursuing it with eager feet until it joins some larger way where many paths and errands meet, and whither then I cannot say. The road goes ever on and on, out from the door where it began. Now far ahead the road has gone. Let others follow if they can, it who can. Let them a journey new begin, but at last, with weary feet, will turn towards the lighted inn, my evening rest and sleep to meet.
Thanks, Bill, man. Up next, Jacob and Lizzie have elected to do a wine box ceremony. Jacob and Lizzie have asked their parents and grandparents to write them letters of advice and encouragement. These letters will be locked in this wine box with a bottle of wine. And for their 1-year anniversary, they will open the box, they will open the wine, and they will open the letters and share in another special evening together. Would the parents, followed by the grandparents, please step forward and place their letters in the wine box? Jacob and Lizzie, are you ready to embark on a wonderful new adventure? May we have the rings. Let us read the vows. Jacob, do you take Lizzie to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you pledge to be her best friend, her shoulder to cry on, her life love? Do you promise to be there for her, not only in the good times, but also when times get tough?
I do.
Jacob, by placing this ring on Lizzie's hand, you are promising to love her freely and unconditionally for the rest of your lives together. Lizzie, do you take Jacob to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you pledge to be his best friend, his shoulder to cry on, his life love? Do you promise to be there for him not only through the good times, but also when times get tough?
I do.
Lizzie, by placing this ring on Jacob's hand, you are promising to love him freely and unconditionally for the rest of your lives together. It's now time for the hand fasting ceremony. This ceremony was started in ancient Scotland and is likely one of the oldest marital traditions on earth. It is also where we get the phrase to tie the knot. Jacob and Lizzie will place their hands atop one another and be bound together not only in body, but in spirit. I would like to ask my Aunt Barb, the lovely mother of the bride, to step forward and perform this ceremony.
Yes.
We're almost through. All right. Finally, Lizzie and Jacob would like all of their closest friends and family to share in this moment. So if everyone would please rise, we are all going to pronounce them man and wife. So on the count of three, one, two, three. We now pronounce you man and wife. Jacob, you may kiss the bride. May I pronounce for the first time ever, Mr. and Mrs. Jacob Stevens.